Now I'm sorry for the delay. I said analysis of variance is what we're going to be looking at today. Then for short, we call it ANOVA. Now it is an extreme use technique concerning researches in many fields of economics, biology, education, psychology, sociology, business or industry, and in the researches. So this is an analysis of variance. We call it for that. It is a technique used when multiple sample cases are involved. Last time I told us, I said we should go and download F distribution table and chi square tables and the rest. Hope we've all gotten that, because we'll be using that to solve here. Now, ANOVA technique enables us to perform or examine the significance of differences among more than two samples. For example, you have more than two samples, you use them and you want to test for their significance. You use ANOVA to test for their significance. You use ANOVA to test for their significance. And in using this, there are different steps that will follow, which we'll go see very soon. ANOVA is a procedure for testing the difference among groups of data. It is a procedure. So now what we are interested in today is looking at some examples. Now let's go look at this example. A group of psychiatric patients are testing three different therapies: counseling, medication, and biofeedback. Now we want to see here if one therapy is better than the other. So what do we do? Now number two is here in this example one, we bring in the ANOVA to test, get the samples to test if there are significant differences, or if one sample is better than other, or one therapy better than other. Then another example is this: a manufacturer has two different processes to make light bulb. They want to know if one process is better than the other. So you use ANOVA to carry out this thing. Then the thirdly, students from different institutions, JPTS Institute, UNILAG, LASU, now takes the same exam. And we want to see which one performed better than the other. So, and this is what ANOVA is. We have two types of ANOVA. We have one-way ANOVA, and we also have two-way ANOVA. One-way ANOVA is only one factor is investigated. When you are investigating only one factor, that is one independent variable with two levels. So analysis of variance is used for this. Then when we talk of two-way ANOVA, it has two independent variables. Then it can be called, it can have multiple levels, and a two-way ANOVA can be used, analysis of variance can be used to do this. So with the two-way ANOVA, we have the replication and the group, but currently, because of our time, let's go into some examples. You can read up all this on our own. Now let's look at some examples and solving this. One-way ANOVA, we have the null hypothesis. Now the null hypothesis, which is denoted by H0, is for the test that the mean are equal. The mean is to tell that, okay, the means are equal. Therefore, a significant result, a result means that the matters are unequal. So now the null hypothesis accept that, okay, the results are not equal. Now let's take situation one. We might be studying the effect of tea on weight loss and from three groups: the green tea, black tea, and no tea. So now we want to find out the effect of tea on weight losses. Now, if we look at two, we might be studying leg strength of people also. We'll look at the obese, the overweight, and the normal, what is their leg strength. So if you see the table we are currently seeing now, this is the tables for ANOVA, analysis of variance. Now we have the source of variation. We have sum of squares, which is denoted by SS. We have degree of freedom, which we call DF. And we have mean square, which is MS. And we have F ratio, that is the mean square between and all over mean square within. So these are what we'll be looking at. So if we go down to my next slide, we'll see the source, the similar thing. If we go back to my next slide, we see similar thing, which is we have the between treatment, which is SSB, and this is talking about the sum of squares, SS, the sum of squares, degree of freedom, mean square, and all the rest. Now, where X is individual observation, X is individual observation from my table. What you see in the next slide, X is individual observation. Then XJ is sample mean of the jet treatment, sample mean of the jet treatment or group. Then X bar is the overall sample mean. X bar is the overall sample mean. Then we have the K. The K is the group of treatment or independent comparison groups. And the N is the total number of observation or total samples. Then this is the formula for this. We have to calculate the between treatment sum of square, we have SSB is equal to summation NJ into SJ bar minus X bar squared. So, and we compute all this. And to calculate for the error sum of squares, we use SSE, which is a double summation bracket open and close S minus the mean, then all squared. Then we also have to calculate the total sum of squares. Then we use SST for to denote the total sum of squares, which is equal to sum or double sum into X minus mean all squared. So, and it's computed by summing. This is computed by summing the differences between each observation and the overall sample mean. So now let's look at the steps to calculate this. The first step we're going to look, the step to calculate all the means. One, you need to calculate all the means for all the groups in the question. Then you also need to calculate the overall mean with all the data combined as one group. So for now, let's take step two, set up the null and alternate hypothesis and the alpha. The null hypothesis denoted by H0, which will have the mu 1, which is equal to mu 2, which is equal to mu 3. And the alternate hypothesis is HA, which is mu 1 is not equal to mu 2, mu 2 is not equal to mu 3. Then we calculate the sum of squares. To calculate the sum of squares, we now say SS total is equal to summation X J bar minus mean all squared to calculate it. So, and we also calculate the sum of square within the groups. And this is the sum of squares within each group. You calculate the sum of squares within each group. So, and to calculate that, we have XS within is equal to double sum J equal to 1 to K and J equal to 1 to L, which gives us X minus X bar all squared. So please know that you have to calculate the two sum of the squares. You can go ahead also to calculate the third on using the first two values in the formula or using the formula. And what is this saying is, if you have, for example, you have three different groups, you have to calculate the squares, the mean one after the other for the groups and adding all of them together. So for excess between, we have excess between is equal to J equals 1 summation K into XJ bar minus mean all squared. And this is, you can verify that the sum, total sum of the squared is equals total sum of between plus total sum of within. So that will give you the total sum of the square. And for another one, you can calculate also, you also expected to calculate the degree of freedom. The degree of freedom is calculated using df is equals n minus 1, where n is the total number of all the data sets combined. Now, let's say, for example, we have 5 in number and we want to calculate the degree of freedom. So it's now going to be our n is now 5, it's now 5 minus 1. So our df, degree of freedom, will now be 4. So, and we also calculate the degree of freedom within group. That is, the df within is equals k minus 1, where k is the number of groups. If there are 3 groups of measurement, then k is equals 3. So, and which, if you apply the formula, it will now give you 3 minus 1, meaning the degree of freedom within is 1, is 2. The degree of freedom between groups, that one is degree is equal to n minus k, and you already know what n is. So, like the example I've made, and you can do this also by saying degree of freedom is equal to, if to verify that you are right, the degree of freedom is equal to the degree of freedom within plus the degree of freedom between. So that gives you the total sum of the degree of freedom. Then another thing you look about is the mean square between. The mean square between, sometimes denoted by MSB, this is equal to SS between all over degree of freedom between. So, and that gives us the answer. So when we look again, you can calculate the mean squares within MSW, and the mean square within is equal to SS within all over the degree of freedom within. So, and gives you the answer. So the next we'll look at is create a summary table of the calculation you've done and the F statistics. And to get the F statistics, you take F is equals MS between all over MS within. Now, after this, you now look up your answer in the statistical table, in the F distribution table. Let's quickly take an example because of our time. Let's quickly take an example. Please, if you can see my screen, just, I would advise you, just screenshot it and let's do something. Number one. Example one, set up an analysis of variance table for the following per acre production data for 3 varieties of wheat, each grown on 4 plots, and state if the varieties differences are significant. So now you can, thank you. You can see that now we have the plots of land 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we have the varieties of wheat 8, 1, A, B, and C. So, and we have their values there. So now we want to start working on it. Now, to obtain the mean of each sample, don't forget, I said we have to obtain the mean of each sample. To obtain this, we have S1 bar. S1 bar is equal to 6 plus 7 plus 3 plus 8. If you check the formula, if you go back and check the formula, the table I gave to you, these are what are under X1. So you divide, you add everything under X1 and divide by the total number. There are 4 numbers there and we divide by 4, and that is what we have 24 all over 4, and which gives us 6. That is the mean for X1 now is 6. The same thing applicable to 2 and 3, and we have the answers there. Then the next thing to do now is to find the mean of the sample, or what some people call the sample mean. Mean of sample mean, or the sample, that is the mean of the mean of what you have collected. So we now have x bar bar into x 1 bar plus x 2 bar plus x 3 bar all over k, and k is the total number of the mean. So when we add all the mean results or figures we got from x1, x2, x3, we have 6 plus 5 plus 4 all over the total, and which gives us 3. And when you simplify that, you compute that, it gives us 5. Then what again we're going to look at, we're going to work out between and within samples, between and within samples, SS between and SS within. And this will give us, from the formula I showed us earlier on, so we now have N1 into X1 bar minus X bar bar, which is the mean now, sample mean minus mean of sample mean. Sample mean minus mean of sample mean all squared, plus N2 into mean 2 minus mean of sample mean all squared plus N3 into mean 3 minus mean of sample mean squared. So when we impute our figures, now the number, like I told you, I said N is the number of samples. The number of samples we have is 4. Now we now have N1 now is 4 into our mean 1 is 6. And the total mean or the mean of mean is 5. So that's why we have 6 minus 5 all squared from the the formula. So when we impute everything, we should be able to have our answer. They will have the answer as 8. Then we can do the same thing for the within mean, and we have the answer as 24. Now here we now calculate for the total variance. The total variance, which is SS total, is equal summation xij into mean of sample mean squared. So when we impute the values of this, we have the 32 as our answer. So if now the we can also do is calculate the SS total variance by using SS for total is equals, like I told you before, SS between plus SS within, and that gives us 32. You could see that we have the same thing. So after that, we draw out our table. We draw out our table. The next slide you've seen, we draw out the table, the SSS, this as the degree of freedom, the mean sample, the F ratio, and everything. By the time we have this table, we have 5% level of confidence. Now, please, I want you to know that if you check the table, you might not get 5%, but rather 5% will give us 0.05. So you can see something like 0.05. So that is, they can give you, we can give you alpha is equal to 0.05 or 95. All you just need to, or 95%, all you just need to do is to divide by 100 and you get the value. So from here now, we have our F. Now from the F as 2 and 9. So when we look up to the table, the F distribution table, which I asked you to download, look for 2 on top the table at the vertical, and look, sorry, at the horizontal, and look for 9 at the horizontal. Where 2 and 9 intersect, I think you will have this 4.26. You will have this 4.26, which is our answer. You have the 4.26. So now from the above, now let's conclude from our calculation. The table we've been able to calculate shows that the calculated value of F is 1.5, which is less than the table value of F, which is 4.6 at 5%. So the level of degree of freedom between 1 and 2 and 2 and 9 could have risen due to chances. So with this, now we say this analysis supports the null hypothesis of no difference in sample mean. So this tells us that there are no difference in sample mean. Why? Because the calculated F calculated is not equal to, so the F calculated is not greater than the F table, is not greater than the F table. So this supports that the null hypothesis is no different in sample mean. Now the differences in width output due to variety is insignificant and is just a matter of chance. Now this means that the variety is not so much differ from each other. Now let's quickly look at another one which we can get another thing. Now the agricultural output may be classified on the basis of different varieties of seed and also on the basis of different varieties of fertilizers used. Now a businessman have its sales data classified on the basis of different salesmen and also on the basis of sales in different regions. Now we are using two-way ANOVA for this. So the two-way ANOVA, one measurement variable. So we're going to use two-way ANOVA to solve this. So because of our time, let's take an example of two-way ANOVA. Now let's take this. It said set up, now this example, this is a setup analysis of variance table. So we have the varieties of seed. We have A, 6, 7, 8, 3 and 8, and we have the B, 5, 5, 3, 7, and we have C, 5, 4, 3, 4. And these are the varieties of fertilizers, W, X, Y, and Z. So we are going to use this to solve. Now, the first thing we're going to do is to obtain the total value of individuals, the total value of individuals. So when we sum up everything, we have 60. It's here we have 60. So we have T is equal 60 and N is equals 12. The total number is equals 12. The N is the number of sample. YT is the sum of all individual samples. Now let's calculate correction factor. Correction factor is equal square of total value all over number of samples. So the correction factor now is T squared all over N, now which we have 60 squared all over 12, and that gives us 300. That gives us 300. That gives us 300. That gives us 300. Now, step two, we have to calculate the total sum of squares. The total sum of squares, that is TSS or SST, and that will give us squares of all the item values minus correction factor. Squares of all the items value minus correction factor. Now, the all the item values you have, you square all of them and you subtract it from the correction factor, and which we have 332 or 332 minus 300, and we have 32. So we have total sum of squares to be 32. So you come to the table, you impute them there. You could see the way I simplified it on my table, individual values, squaring, then the result of squaring. So you could see all of them, the result of squaring. I'm tabulating it gradually because at the end, this will make it easier for me. So at the end, everything will be totally summed together. Everything will be on the table. Then the next steps we're going to look at is to calculate the sum of squares between columns treatment. So, and this is going to give us sum of all squares of individual column all over sample in column, and this will give us the correction factor. So sum of all squares or sum of all squares of individual columns. So we now have for column one, we have the square root of 24 all over 4, the square root of 20 all over 4 plus the square root of 24 all over 4 plus the square root of 20 all over 4 plus the square root of 16 all over 4 minus the sample column, which is minus the 60 squared all over 12. And this is, when we open it up, it will give us 8. And you can see I also brought it to the table. It's also on the table, so I will not, it will not give me much problem later. Now, the step four we're going to look at here, we're going to look at step four, which is calculating between rows. So sum of mean between rows treatment, and this is the formula for this is sum of all squares of individual rows all over number of samples minus correction factor. So when we open it up, just the same way you are looking at it on my screen, it will give us 18. It will give us 18. So, and this is how we're going to do them until we get to the step number five. We have to follow is the sum of square residual or errors, and this is equal to the total sum of squares minus sum of squares between columns plus sum of squares between rows, which is the total sum of squares we had was 32. So 32 minus 8 plus 18, that will give us 6. Now, and the next one we'll be looking at now is to find the degree of freedom, the degree of freedom for variance between column, that is C minus 1, or like the previously we said K minus 1. So now we have three columns and we now have 3 minus 1 will give us 2. So the degree of variance between rows, we have 4 rows, so we now that will have 4, that is R minus 1. So that will now give us 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. And we'll also go look for another one, the degree of variance for residual variance, the degree of freedom for residual variance, that is C minus 1, bracket open and close, C minus 1 into bracket open and close, R minus 1. And we have, for C, we have a 2, and for R, we have 3. So 2 times 3 will give us the degree of freedom for the degree of freedom for residual variance. Now we now talk about the total degree of the degree of freedom for total variance. That will give us C multiplied by R minus 1. That is, we have our C as 3, we have our C as 3, and we have our R minus 1, and that is we now have 3 minus, well, 3 times 4, that is give us 12 minus 1, and that will give us the total variance, which is 11. So we have, finally, we have these quantitative values. We have been able to have this quantitative value, the SS between column, the SS between row, the residual, the degree of freedom between row, between column, between the residual variance and total variance. So we bring out the ANOVA table, and this is just the way it is here, the ANOVA table. And we've been able to do all this. So I hope we got this thing clearly. Please, I will advise us to also read up on our own about it, because we do not have much time. But for the sake of time, let's quickly take an assignment. And okay, assignment, let's go. Please, let's write. If you can see the screen, you can pick it from the screen. Suppose the National Transportation Safety Board wants to examine the safety of compact cars, mid-size cars, and full-size cars. It collects all samples of 3 for each of the treatments, that is car types. Using the hypothetical data provided below, test whether the mean pressure applied to the driver's head during a crash test is equal for each type of car. Use alpha as 5%. I go over it again. Suppose the National Transportation Safety Board wants to examine the safety of compact cars, mid-size cars, and full-size cars. It collects a sample of 3 for each of the treatments. Using the hypothetical data provided below, which is the table you are seeing, test whether the mean pressure applied to the driver's head during a car crash test is equal for each type of car. Use alpha as 5%. Then A, state the null and alternative hypothesis. B, calculate the appropriate test statistics. And C, obtain the critical value decision rule. And D, interpret your findings. So I expect every one of us to try this assignment, and let's know what you were able to get from it. Now, again, there is another assignment I want to get. No, assignment number two, please. Let's take it down. Set up ANOVA table for the following information relating to 3 drugs testing to judge the effectiveness in reducing blood pressure for 3 different groups of people. Set up the ANOVA table for the following information relating to the 3 drugs testing to judge the effectiveness in reducing blood pressure for 3 different groups of people. So this, as you can see on the table, on my table, please, I prefer if you screenshot it. Now, question A, do the drugs act differently? B, are the different group of people affected differently? And C, is the interaction terms significantly? Is the interaction term significant? Is the interaction term significant? Please, let's submit this assignment not later than Saturday and same time, 23:59:59 p.m. Let's have it. Please, I would like you to try it, to try it, to try it. It's very, very important you try it, do it, know it, master it. So from the formulas we've been able to deduce, please go study one way ANOVA, two way ANOVA, and you can solve these things effectively. You can solve these things effectively. So I want to say thank you again for listening to me. I want to say I've enjoyed this class so far. Thank you very much for since the inception, though we have some kind of technical challenges, which was later resolved. I want to thank you for your patience, for everything, and for staying tuned with us. Thank you very much. I enjoy. Please don't forget, the assignments are very, very important. I state the steps for you to solve them. We've talked about them. Now, let me quickly talk about how you're going to work on the two-way ANOVA. One, you have to get the sum of all individuals. You have to get the sum of all individuals. Two, you calculate the correction error. Get the sum of all individuals. Step two, calculate the errors. Three, calculate the total sum of squares. The total sum of squares, and which I said the formula is squares of all the item values minus correction factor. Minus correction factor. And the next one you calculate is the sum of squares between column treatments. So, and that is equal to sum of all squares of individual columns all over sample in columns minus correction factor. Minus correction factor. And don't forget, I showed us how we could solve all this. And the next step is to solve the sum of squares between rows treatment. And I said the formula for that is sum of all squares of individual rows all over sum of sample minus correction factor. And we also talk about the sum of squares residual or errors, which I said sum of square, total sum of square residual is total sum of squares minus sum of squares between plus sum of squares minus sum of squares between columns plus sum of squares between rows, and it will give you the end. Lastly, we'll talk about finding the degree of freedom, which I showed you.